Dr. Cullis is being awarded alongside Drs. Drew Weissman and Dr. Catalin Carrico. Dr. Cullis is being awarded for their pioneering work developing nucleoside-modified mRNA and lipid nanoparticle drug delivery, the foundational technologies for the highly effective COVID-19 mRNA vaccines, and really the reason that we're all here today. Dr. Cullis has chosen, "You can't always get what you want, but sometimes you get what you need," by the Rolling Stones. Come on up, Dr. Cullis.
Don't you love that music? Can't always get what you want, but sometimes you get what you need. The Gairdner, I only got 10 pages to go here, you have nothing to worry about. If my voice sounds a little strange, I don't have COVID, I got tested, you know, I passed the test. I love that one bar, not two. The Canada Gairdner International Award recognizes outstanding researchers whose unique scientific contributions, etc., have contributed to relief of human suffering. So it's really an amazing honor to receive this award. And so, the reasons that I'm getting this award are great examples of how sometimes you get what you need, not what you want. Sometimes you do get what you want. It's really the case when I met the beautiful Nancy Flight 42 years ago. We had three dates, and then we decided to get married. Certainly the best thing that ever happened to me, but Nancy's sometimes not quite so sure. But Nancy and our two beautiful children, Jeffrey and Jane, are here tonight. How great that is. Now in science, as it turns out, it's more often you don't get what you want, but you get something that you need. And I'll give a couple of examples of this. I got a PhD in physics in 1972. And I realized that I really didn't want to go on in physics. It was really very difficult to discover something new because there weren't very many women around either, let me put it this way. So I switched to biochemistry, much better, as a postdoc in Oxford. That was quite an experience. I didn't know what a protein was, what DNA was, or anything, but I did get some of what I expected. Life sciences is such an exciting area, but I also got something I didn't expect what I needed. I saw a really good cartoon the other day. It was a little boy standing at a bus stop, looking at all the traffic and the people and everything else whizzing by, and the caption in the balloon that was coming out of his mouth was, "How old do you have to be before you understand what's going on?" Don't you love that? That's really great. I realized why at Oxford, while I may not know what's going on, most others don't either. I still find it very comforting. It gave me a lot of confidence that's enabled much of my career. I didn't know much about biochemistry or anything, and that worked out all right. So why not try to develop drugs? That worked out too, so why not try to develop companies as well? And that's worked out as well. It's a great theme, you know. You gotta try stuff, otherwise nothing happens. In the mid-1980s, I realized that lipid-based systems had some real potential as drug delivery systems. I was really saying, okay, well, that's cancer is a big one, right? So I started to use them as agents to deliver cancer drugs to get them more specifically to tumors, which is still a huge need. But we couldn't, I went so far as to establish a company, and we couldn't raise enough money to keep the whole thing going. And the CEO said to me one day, you know, we got to be doing gene therapy. His words were, it has much more sex appeal to investors. So he had to switch gears. And it turned out that as a result of switching gears, we didn't cure cancer, but we ended up enabling many forms of gene therapies. Really kind of unbelievable. You don't always get what you want, but sometimes you get what you need. So in the early 2010s, we were working hard to make lipid nanoparticles make proteins in the liver. And as you'll hear later from Drew, you won't hear this necessarily, but he called up and said, I'd like to try your lipid nanoparticles as vaccines. And that worked rather brilliantly, ending up enabling the COVID-19 vaccines. Again, you don't always get what you want, but sometimes you really get what you need. I just want to close by saying that I've been very lucky to have the things you really need, namely the people that I've worked with, the teams that I've been part of, and the fun that we've had. So back in 1985, the four postdocs and I started our first company called Lipex Biomembranes. And we'd invented a device to make lipid nanoparticles, turned out to be quite popular, decided to form a company to make and sell it. And we were advised by business people that we really had to have something called a mission statement. Yeah, don't you like that? They were quite serious about this. And I usually agree with Oscar Wilde's advice, re-advice. He said, I always pass along good advice. There's not much else to do with it. But in this case, I took the advice. We came up with the best mission statement I've ever heard. It was free beer every Friday and parties whenever possible. Nobody in my lab has paid for a beer since, and we've had some pretty good parties. So the best thing that I've needed the most has been the people working with me. I'm still working with the people that I formed Lipex, the first company, with over 40 years ago. And it's due to them that we're now the drug delivery capital of the world with 400 employees and a huge market capital in the billions. And together, we came up with the lipid nanoparticles that enabled the COVID-19 mRNA vaccines, to use a Canadian expression, not bad, eh? So thank you very much for this award, and I'm greatly honored. But it really belongs to the people that I've worked with, the incredible people I've worked with over a lifetime. It's been such a privilege and such a joy. So thank you very much.